So allow me to look at this and conclusion on this. Allow me to look at this. When you look there, you find that we started with the Israelites. Israelites had ordinances, they had commandments, they had promises. And then we go to whosoever, when they rejected Christ, we go to whosoever would believe in Christ, will be saved by grace through faith. And that has been happening. This has been happening for the time of the Gentiles. So this has been taking place for the time of the Gentiles. This is the time for the Gentiles. Until the fullness of the time of the Gentiles is done, that's when these people, they can also participate here. But they will not be leaders. They will be servants because they rejected Christ. So God would not use them like this in order to save the world. He couldn't use them like that. So he had to abandon them. He had to use the grace and all the Gentiles. He had to use the Gentiles to be leaders and use the grace. Now the Gentiles during the 3.5 period, and the Bible here in the book of Revelation also gives a number of days, in terms of days, 1,000 plus of days. I haven't read that. But then, that when the fullness of time is done, when the fullness of time is done, you would find that the dragon, the red dragon, will now move to the Israelites who are hiding in the wilderness. When he moves into the Israelites who are hiding in the wilderness, it will be there in order for them to destroy, in order for him to destroy them. But he will not destroy them. So that's the time we know that the time of the Gentiles is coming to an end. And now the time of the Gentiles has finally come to an end. How do you get to know that the time of the Gentiles has come to an end? There is one thing. In 1948, the Israelites became independent. But when they became independent, the wars and all the battles never came to an end. They have continued. They are still there. So which means they are coming into that land has not brought any easy, does not brought any rest to them in any way. So, which means they do not fulfill the scriptures, which say that when I have brought you back, you shall be in rest and you shall also be in easy. They haven't been easy, they haven't been in rest. But then, that's what makes us know. Immediately, this revelation has been coming up. Over the sudden, almost everyone, everywhere, the Bantus are saying we are Israelites. Everywhere. Try to Google, try to check. Try to check. This is not just like it's just coming up like that. There should be something. There should be the work and the hand of God. I don't think it's the devil who's bringing up all this. And when all these things are coming up, they're not coming up without evidence. If you are coming up without evidence, we can just throw it off. I'm a Bible student, of course. Well taught in the Word of God. So I wouldn't really want to lose my salvation. I wouldn't want you to go into something which cannot help me in any way. But when we look into it, I say, okay, if we can accept this, and the proofs of this has been proven only by the mighty men of God, not biblically, how much more something which is being proved by historically, proved by linguistics in terms of the sounds of the words, proved by our culture? Our culture is all Israel, all Old Testament. That's how our culture is. You don't need, proved by the names of all the fathers in the Bible. The next teaching that I'm going to is to talk about the names of all the fathers in the Bible so that you can get to know that this is not a made up thing. How can we get to know all the names and all the names make sense in my language, without any difficulties? So also in terms of the history that we have, and also the names of our towns, what they mean, they are all Hebrew names. How could we make Hebrew names, which is not our language, we say Zambia? How can we call Zambia? Zambia is Yambezi. Yambezi is Yahweh, Jehovah. Yah, Jehovah. Mbe is origin. That's what it means, original. Then Ji is She, which is salvation, which means Yahweh is the original Savior. That's what Zambia means. So how should we put up all, everything in us? It is all Hebrew. My tribe is Kaonde. Kaonde is Yaonde. Yaonde is Yehudi. Yehudi is Judah, the tribe of Judah. And it is Luba, Kaonde. You change Luba, you make it Yuba, which is a clan of him, which is a clan of Judah. And the language of Hebrew has got the tendency of changing the consonants. So that's the thing. So we are not just trying to talk about this, talk about that, no. But how does it that relate to the church? So you can see from there, the Hebrews failed, and then the grace took up with Pauline, and has been managing, but has been a weak one. Now we are moving on here, moving to the Israelites again. So when these Israelites, black Israelites or white Israelites, whatever you can take, when these who are Israelites come into the play, which is happening now, they're gonna make the grace work so strong. Why are they going to make strong the grace work? Because of the scripture I read. I read that these are the people that keep the commandments of God and the commandments of life of God, and they also what? Keep the what, the testimony of Christ. So these two must be together. So they will get this, they will get the commandments of life, not of death, of life, put them together, and then the church is going to become without wrinkle. You must know that God is coming, Jesus Christ is coming for a church without wrinkle, a church without a spot, a church that is righteous. If it is given, it is left in the hands of the church today, everything left in the hands of church today, we can even give it even maybe 2,000 years, there will be nothing happening. There will be no purity. We shall just be fighting and fighting and fighting, like firefighting. But once the leadership changes, the Hebrews who were neglected now come back. They take up the leadership. And then they say, you guys now get behind us. We are going to show you how the leadership is done, how to worship our God is done. Now we are hungry. We are so hungry. We have been away for a long time. We want him. Then we accept the testimony of Christ, of our salvation. We accept it. And we also are not going to be harmful to his commandments. So the commandments of life, we are going to uphold them because they support our physical stay on the earth and the nature and everything about ourselves. So we're going to keep it, and then righteousness will start happening immediately. There's a difference, not righteousness only, holiness. There is a difference between holiness and righteousness. Righteousness is a right standing between God and me. Righteousness is a right standing between me and my neighbor. That is righteousness and error. That is righteousness. So you are made righteous when you believe in Christ Jesus. You are made righteous because you've got a line now of salvation. You are saved. You are made righteous, even with yourself and with your neighbor. But that does not mean you are holy. Holiness, you've got to work on it. Holiness is progressive. Holiness can come with discipline. And how does discipline come with? You need the laws of life. When you keep the laws, the don'ts and the do's, and you start disciplining yourself, then you become holy. But how you discipline yourself? God will provide the grace. He provides a grace, as he provides a grace, but there should be a willingness for you to do something in order for you to achieve that. So the issue today, the church is going to be taken in terms of leadership by the Israelites. And when it is taken up by the Israelites, what is going to happen is that the Israelites are going to live a holy life, total holy life within the church context, such that the other nations who are Christians, when they see the righteousness of this leadership of the Jew of Israelites, they will say that we have heard that God is in your group. God is in your midst. We want to go with you so that we can just... Yeah, we continue. So that's what is going to happen. Now the church going to come together. When it comes, the leadership is changed hands, and then the people shall see. Now, you know what has been happening. All this time, what has been happening is that under the leadership of the Gentile leadership in Christianity, it is like the leadership of the people of Israel have crossed the Red Sea, and Moses has gone up the mountain, and Aaron has remained with them. Then they are celebrating beneath the mountain. And then Aaron says that, guys, how were you seen? How did you see God? How do you see God when you were crossing? Then the other one, no, me, I saw God, he was just like a bird. The other one said that, no, me, I saw God, he was like this and that. Then Aaron said, no, me, I saw God like he was like a what? He was like a cow. He was like a cow. Oh, he was like a cow. Oh, yes. So then can I make up something like a cow? Then they make up a cow. Then they start giving it, worshipping it, and dancing around it, and worshipping it. That's what the church has been this time. The church has been, sometimes we have been joking. Sometimes we have been going round and round and round and round. We don't know what we are doing. But then, when someone had seen God up the mountain, because God is up the mountain, so this time, with this type of leadership of the Israelites, the true Israelites, we are going to climb the mountain. We will be at the top of the mountain. And the scriptures shall be fulfilled, that the mountain of the Lord shall be lifted up higher than any other mountain, higher than any government. It will be the highest mountain, and everyone shall see it. Who are going to lift it up? These people who were rejected, who are now brought back. They now embrace their Christ. They will now lift up Jesus Christ higher. And when that is happened, then all the people of the world shall see, and there shall be salvation. And the Bible says, for no one during that time shall tell his neighbor, know the Lord, for everyone shall know the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Selah. God bless you.